One, and here I even agree with my friend, although right-winger, but we can learn from conservative, intelligent right-wingers, Peter Sloterdijk, who said the problem today is we don't have enough alienation. We have to, we should break this politically correct, multiculti stupidity. We have to understand the other. No, how can we understand the others when they don't understand themselves, when we don't understand ourselves? Let's say I live in a building where there are some Persians, some Arabs, some blacks, some Latinos, whatever you want, some Chinese. I don't want to understand them. I want to live a respectable life where we respect each other, friendly, say hello. And I absolutely, not because they are what they are, maybe I can become friendly with some of them, probably more preferable than friendly with from my own nation. No? But what I'm saying is that, you know, this idea of just understanding, coming together, I think that quite, you know what is for me the basic, the beauty of alienation? Politeness. Politeness is all about alienation. What is politeness? Sorry to use my old example. Politeness is, I meet you on the street, and this is not real you, but maybe. Let's say, for what reason I hate you, but I don't. And I meet you, and of course, before I notice you, I start to curse. Why didn't I notice you 3 seconds before so that I could cross the... end. But then, when I see you, we have to say, hello, nice to see you, how are you? Now, listen to the paradox. We both know that I don't think that it was nice to see you, and that I don't give a shit about how are you. But nonetheless, it's politeness. It's, in a way, a sincere lie. The message is much more refined. The message is not, I am lying. But the message is, even if I am now in a bad mood and don't care about you, nonetheless, there is a certain fundamental acceptance, benevolence, and so on and so on. It would be, in other words, politeness, in the sense of this basic alienation of language, that you don't say what you mean. It gives you the breathing space, my God. And here, I think, with the help of Freud and Lacan, we should correct Marx. I think that the whole topic of literally, we need more alienation. Why this hermeneutically imperialist approach, we should understand them, we should understand them. My second dogma here is the only practical understanding that works is struggle. Not with the enemy, but solidarity in struggle. I hate another candidate for that Goebbels book burning. You know, those, they were popular when I was young, those UNESCO books describing all the world cultures, you know, how beautiful this, that culture, that's disgusting. My point is that we in our culture have our own conflicts, antagonisms. They have their own conflicts. The only authentic universality is the universality of struggle. To discover that our struggle is part of the same struggle as them.